Hi, good morning, everybody. This is Mary Shores coming in live from Champaign, Illinois to have a discussion this morning about how to harness the power within. So I've been working the last couple of weeks on a series that I'm going to be calling, I just forgot the title. It's amazing how nervous I can get as soon as that camera goes live. But it's, the power of personal creation. Yeah, so the first part of it is the power of personal creation. And what is that power? Harnessing the power within is all about the power of vision, the power of focus, the power of belief, the power of your body, the power of choice, the power of your words, the power of authenticity, the power of mindset, the power of action, and the power of mastery. So that's what we're going to be talking about. These are 10 different power virtues, and today we're going to start with the power of vision. I did post, so I've made these power thought cards to go along with the series. So if you are a part of the Fearless Ambition newsletter, these will be sent to you on Tuesday morning. They're beautiful. The amazing Roxanne illustrated them all, and I've printed these out on just regular Kodak photo paper, and you can cut them, and I'm going to post them around my office, I think. So, the power of vision. And when I'm talking about vision, it's really about having a grand vision, meaning that you know exactly what you want, and you know exactly how to produce the results that you're looking for. And my question this week was, rate yourself on a scale, if I were to ask you right now, on a scale of 0 to 10, where are you at with your vision? So 0 meaning you feel absolutely clueless, you don't even know what I'm talking about, you feel like you have no vision, purpose, or mission, and you're really just at that ground level, and that can feel very frustrating. With 10 being that you have a vision, you know how to get there, you're ready to go, and you are pumped. So 5, somewhere in the middle, is, you know, perhaps you have a vision, you know what you want, but you're not really sure what are the steps that you need to take to get there. So myself, I'm probably around a 7 right now. And so I wanted to start off the discussion by talking about two things: grand ambition and drive. And so, you know, the name of the group is Fearless Ambition, and it's all about finding fearless ambition. But the truth is, it doesn't mean that we're fearless. It's that we understand the power of overcoming our fears in order to take us to that next level of what we really want. So when we're talking about grand ambition, it's how do you set your goals and how do you have high expectations, high standards? And then the part about grand ambition is, as soon as you start to get there, raise that goal up, because the truth is that the higher you set your goal, the higher you're going to achieve. So if you set a goal of 10,000 units of whatever, then you're really more likely, you might not get 10,000, but you're way more likely to get 5,000 than if your goal had only been, say, 2,000 to begin with. And the second part about drive is, you know, not being interested in empty dreams, having a willingness to gain the skills necessary to execute and be a finisher. So that's sort of something that's going to be an all encompassing over all 10 of these powerful virtues. So, vision. When you are at a 0 on your vision. I was there. In 2008, I was going through a divorce. I felt very shut down. I felt like life was pretty much over, and I thought that all of the success that I had achieved up until that point in life wasn't going to last very much longer. And this feeling of being at 0 really lasted for a couple of years. So if you're feeling like you're at 0, then what we need to do is, instead of thinking about vision as this entire empire or whatever, this big thing that you're trying to create, think about what is the next thing that you need. Even if that next thing that you need is just support to get through your day. So your vision can be something very, very small. So the smaller that you break it down when you're feeling like you're at a zero, the quicker you're going to be able to move up that scale to get to higher and higher numbers. So what happened for me was it was about 2 years, and eventually I started saying, I know that I'm supposed to be doing something else, but I wasn't really very confident or sure about what it was that I was supposed to be doing. And then things started to pivot. And I started to get all these ideas flooding into me very, very rapidly. But I went through this 2 year period where there was nothing. And that is a great time. So when you're at a zero, or maybe even a 0, 1, 2, or a 3, this is the time to be investing in yourself. And what I mean by investing in yourself is the meta learning, is taking the opportunities of what can you educate yourself on. So what are you attracted to? What are the books that you want to read? What are the videos you want to watch? What is the learning environment you want to be in right now? And whatever you're drawn to, follow that. Because there's something in that that you're supposed to learn. And so for me, when I was in that period, I was very drawn to personal development, and I was extremely drawn to spirituality. So I just started devouring book after book on the topic of spirituality and book after book on the topic of personal development. And I started investing heavily into traveling to as many workshops as I possibly could in order to educate myself. And when I couldn't be in a workshop, I watched the videos. So if I had someone that I wanted to go to their workshop, but either I couldn't afford the travel or I couldn't make the time to go to the workshops, then I would simply find them on YouTube, and I would watch all of the free content that I could find. And if they had a book, I would get their book and read the book. So that really, really worked. And then if you are in that middle point, which is kind of like where I'm feeling like I'm at now, because when you have a vision, even if you're at a level 10, as soon as you start to accomplish even 50% of that vision, you're going to deplete it again, and you're going to start to create new and better visions all the time. So 6 months ago, I was at a total 10, and you know, now that's gone back because I've raised the bar, I've raised the standards of what it is that I'm looking for. So I've gone back down to the drawing board, and it's time to create new action plans for myself to take me where I'm at right now, which is, like I said, around this level 5, to where I want to be, which is the which is everything already accomplished. So again, if you're at a zero, it's really time to invest in yourself, invest in what can you learn each and every day to keep yourself moving in the direction, and just be okay, you know, and invoke the power of patience and understand that this feeling that you're having right now most likely is not going to last forever. So when you're in that middle and it's time to take that vision and really start to move it forward. So you want to get clarity. So you want to be very clear on what your mission is, so you can ask yourself questions. I love the book Start With Why by Simon Sinek. I felt like that book was really life-changing for me because it was a way for me to put vernacular to what I had been feeling about why was the reasons I was doing stuff. So what are the habits, choices, and actions that you're taking every day? So if you have a vision of opening a flower shop, or you have a vision of writing a book, opening a fitness center or creating a brand of any kind, when you can know what your outcome is, then you can actually very simply reverse engineer and start asking yourself the questions. What do you need to be true in order to obtain that outcome? What are the resources you need? Who are the people that you need to be around? You know, who do you want to have in your inner circle? And so, you know, even if that vision is that you want to reach some level of enlightenment, then you ask yourself the same questions, because vision doesn't always have to be about something that is tied to your career. And many times it's not. It can be an inner vision about wanting to be the best version of yourself that you can possibly be. And so I've always also asked the question in the group about what is your superpower. So I was writing the chapter in my book about alter ego. I was really into this idea about who is your favorite superhero. So superheroes, I felt like I got a lot of people that was like, it was Superman and Batman. And just taking those two characters, they're very different from each other. You know, Batman and Bruce Wayne are very flashy, and there's just this completely different energy to those two versus Superman, which Superman is, he's kind of the wants to stay in the background and then like swoop in, and you know, he's really hiding, and he's Clark Kent. So Clark Kent is really very different than Bruce Wayne, obviously. So here's the thing, that when you learn how to figure out what are those superpowers inside of yourself and bring those out, put those parts of yourself in charge. My friend Rocky, who I write about in the book, we have been having these conversations about this, and I got this super exciting phone call from him one morning. It was 7 o'clock in the morning, and he says, "Mary," he's like, "I am on fire. I can't believe it." You know, he was so excited about all of the things that were happening for him, and he goes, "It was because I finally put Braveheart in charge." So his superpower, his inner power, was all about the freedom of William Wallace and Braveheart. And he said, "When I put Braveheart in charge, I felt so unstoppable." So part of being able to fulfill your vision and your mission is you've got to tap into those parts of yourself that you've maybe buried. You've maybe, these are things that people have actually criticized you for, or you felt that maybe you would be judged by those things. So I know for myself, when I just kind of felt on the inside that I knew these things, and I felt this really strong need to start talking about them and teaching other people about them. But my inner talk was more like, who am I to share this information? There's better people that can get it out there. But I for sure, when I was able to tap in to my inner superpower, which I actually said was a cross between Jessica Rabbit and Scarlett O'Hara. So what was, I find this funny. If you know me personally, then you know that I'm very tall and definitely like to get dressed up and can really get behind the character and the virtues of Jessica Rabbit, because Jessica Rabbit might have looked one way on the outside, but on the inside, Jessica Rabbit was all about supporting Roger Rabbit, her man, and she was the epitome of stand by your man, and she would do anything to support Roger Rabbit. But then Scarlett O'Hara, she was really super business brilliant, and she really knew how to make deals, how to negotiate, how to create what she wanted. And then I had this aha moment where I realized and I understood that my life really was like Scarlett, meaning Scarlett always had drama. You know, somebody's always dying, or worse, you know, having to deliver a baby, having to escape danger when from the war. She's always got some kind of drama going on with Rhett. And so I decided very purposely decided that I actually didn't want to be Scarlett anymore. And from now on, I was going to be Dorothy, because Dorothy had the power all along. Dorothy had the unconditional love and support all around her the entire time. And as soon as she learned how to tap into that power, all she had to do was click her heels 3 times and she could make it happen. And so that's my new superpower. I'm Dorothy. And being Dorothy means that I am an unstoppable magnetic creator. So I am going to use my vision, my focus, my beliefs, my body, my choices, my authenticity, my mindset, my mastery. You know, mastery means learning something inside, outside, backwards, and forwards until I can do it without effort. And also the power of action, always taking action. So that is it for this morning. I really hope that you enjoy the video, and I'm happy to answer any questions. I'll probably jump on again and want to deepen the discussion about vision and how to create your vision, how to step into it. Okay, thank you. Bye-bye.
Hey, this is Mary. Thanks so much for watching. Check out a free chapter of my book, Conscious Communications, at maryshores.com/free chapter. The link is in the description below.